So that's shutter done. We'll move on to GCC now, which is probably the largest package to be built. It's also worth noting the amount of time this package takes to build with the tests, an incredible 153 SBU. So if you're on a particularly slow machine, expect it to take several hours, and depending on how slow the machine is, it could take all night or maybe even 24 hours, depending, you know, if it's something like an atom or something, it may well take 24 hours or more to complete the tests. So that's finished building. What I'm going to do now is to get the summary of the tests. And I'll page it with less. I've got less, okay. So let's cat it anyway. Let's try more. Needs to be executed. So some tests are known to fail. ASAN underscore test dot C, it is there. Unable to produce an executable. Then we've got some called bad mapper, which I've never seen before that I can recall. Again, that's maybe down to the modern processor. So I'm not going to worry about that too much. It looks like it's just this last page here. Okay, we're only paging once. G++, so there's a summary of 7 failures there. GCC, again, these are not mentioned. There is a link. They used to have a link here. Yeah, here it is. For build logs that other people have run. This is the LFS ones. They used to have a link. Yeah, here it is. To the GCC developers page where it shows various different machines. Let's just have a quick look at the LFS ones. So there's various different processors here. Test logs. So we want GCC. Let's look for G++ tests. So there's no failures in the same way. So it's a bit difficult to see exactly. Like I said, the process is quite new, so that could be the problem. Let's have a look at the GCC. Let's see if there's any mention of Alder Lake. No. Okay, it's only a small, it's only March 2nd today, let's try February. No, there's nothing there. Okay, it didn't look like there's any report, so just have to go with it, I think. Right, again, there doesn't seem to be any. References there, specifically. And also what I've noticed in the past before is it can depend on how GCC compiles can have an effect on the results. And you can see there for G++, there's only one failure. So it's a bit hit and miss. Certainly if you're compiling on Alder Lake, it'd be quite interesting to know if you've got similar results as I did. So there's 8 in total for GCC. Let's see if we've got any other failures. Locale. Oh, intro headers. Yeah, we've got these ones mentioned here. 49745cc, that's that one there. this numpunct and six tests related to get time. So that's all of those in libstandard C++. So they're catered for or accounted for. So it's just those earlier ones for GCC and G++, which are unaccounted for. And again, that may be because of the new processor. So what I'll do is I'll carry on with the build. Now I do some tests. So again, we're going to create a little dummy C file, compile it, output the log to a log file, and do some little searches in that log file, looking for specific things to ensure that the output is what it says in the book. So for example, this first one should say requesting program interpreter /lib64 ldlinux x86-64.so.2, so that's okay. This next grep should output three lines, and that looks accurate, so that's fine. This should display some include paths, and again, that looks all fine. Check these search paths. It says the ones ending in -linux GNU can be ignored, but otherwise the rest of it does look correct. And 32-bit machine will be slightly different. So that's okay. Check the correct dynamic linker. User lib. LDLinux, yep, that's okay. Clean up the test files and move a misplaced file. And that's GCC complete.